wa viongozi wa Tausi. Basi karibuni sana na Mungu awabariki mnapoendelea kujumuika nasi. Na kwa kuanza, nitaanza kuwakaribisha wote kwa ujumla, lakini vile vile tuanze kwa ombi. Kwa siku ya leo atakayetupatia ombi la kufungua anaitwa Tumaini Lusenga. Tafadhali Tumaini Lusenga, karibu tupatie ombi la kufungua. Tumaini Lusenga, kama hupo, tafadhali tupatie ombi la kufungua. Nafikiri Tumaini hajafika na ninataka kusema kwamba naweza kukaribisha mtu mwingine akatupatia ombi la kufungua. Ni muombe ndugu yangu kiongozi pia wa Tausi, ndugu Isaac Nziacharo atupatie ombi la kufungua. Tafadhali Isaac, karibu tufungulie kwa ombi.
Naweza kunisikia?
Tunakusikia, karibu.
Subiri kidogo hapa. Niko kwenye pilika nyingi hapa, and you'll know what I'm talking about in a minute. Lakini basi tuombe. Tufumbe macho wote tuombe jamani. Mungu wetu na Baba yetu ushinde pepa juu mbinguni, tunashukuru sana kwamba unatupenda, umetuleta mahali hapa sahihi. Mungu wetu, tunapokutana katika Zoom, tunaomba kwamba Roho wako Mtakatifu aweze kuwepo nasi sahihi, mambo tutakayoyasema, tutakayojifunza yawe yale ambayo unataka yatusaidie katika ufalme wako. Viongozi wetu na wote walioweka hii program together, Father, tunakuomba kwamba pamoja nao na wote wanaoingia na ambao wataingia na watakaosikiliza kwenye YouTube and everything else, let there be blessings kwa kila mmoja wetu, na Mungu ajulikane yuko pamoja nasi muda na saa kama hii. Siku ya Sabato jioni, kwa wote walioko hapa, tunaomba baraka wa Sabato waingilie kila mmoja wetu, na utuongoze na utupende na ututarishe katika ufalme wako mpaka siku litakapokuja Mungu wetu, tuwe pamoja tukikula katika mawingu. Asante sana kwa kila jambo unalotufanyia, kuwa pamoja nasi muda na saa kama hii mpaka hapo utakapokuja. Jina la Yesu Kristo tunaomba, amen.
Amen. Amen. Asante ndugu Isaac kwa ombi la kufungua, na asante kwa kujumuika pia katika kipindi hiki. Nipende tu kuendelea kuwakaribisha wote katika saa nzima ya worship na fellowship ambaye ni inaongozwa na Tausi. Nimeshajitambulisha, niseme tu kwa wakati huu kinachofuata ni wimbo wa kufungua. Na kwa siku ya leo Mungu ametubariki, tutakuwa na dada Gesa kutupatia wimbo wa kufungua. Tafadhali dada Gesa, karibu tufungulie kwa wimbo.
Asante sana mwenyekiti wetu wa chapter yetu ya Pacific na Nyuni. Na wakati huu tutapata wimbo kutoka katika kikundi kizuri cha Washington and All Gone. Tumeweza kushirikiana pamoja, japokuwa sitakuwa pamoja nao wako upande wa All Gone, basi tutaweza kuwasikia siku ya leo. Karibuni sana.
Mnanisikia?
Basi mnanisikia? Karibu Isaac.
Mwenyekiti, nilikuwa nakimbia hapa kwa sababu hii timu yote iko hapa.
Amen.
Tunaimba wimbo. Teknolojia ndio hiyo tunajaribu kuitumikia, lakini Mungu ametubariki sana.
Amen.
Kwa hali hiyo, tuwakaribishe kwa wimbo special ya hili grupu lioko hapa. Na Gesa, asante sana kwa kutusaidia, kwa kutuhuka. Asante.
Amen.
Tembea na Yesu, tembea, simama katika zamu yako. maishani mwako na wengara uoneshe dunia uzuri wake tuangaza 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 dunia imone
Nataka kushukuru pia kikundi kizima chilio ambacho kimetupatia wimbo kutoka Oregon kiongozwa na dada Gesa pamoja na ndugu Isaac na wote walioshiriki. Mungu awabariki sana kwa kutubariki. Amina and amina. Nipende kuwakaribisha tena katika kipindi hiki cha Saa Nzima ambacho leo kinasimamiwa kwa uongozi wa Tausi Pacific. Niseme wakati huu tunaofuata sasa katika programu ya kwetu ni kipindi cha kutoa sifa na shukurani. Ninawakaribisha wote popote mlipo muweze kujumuika. Tunaweza kwa mute na kutoa sifa na shukurani chochote ambacho Mungu amekutendea ama shuhuda. Tunawakaribisha sana muweze kushiriki wakati huu. Karibuni. Nina dakika chache kwa ajili ya program hiyo ya sifa, shukurani ama shuhuda. Tafadhali kama uko kwenye sehemu nzuri unaweza kuunmute na kutoa sifa, shukurani ama shuhuda kwa Mungu. Niseme tu kwa niaba ya kundi hili tunamshukuru Mungu kwa uhai ambao tumeupata, ambao tunao mpaka sasa. Hatuna jambo lolote ambalo jema tumefanya ili tuweze kustahili kuwepo mahali hapa. Kila siku tunapoamka ni mbaraka mojawapo wa kuweza kuona siku nyingine. Kwa hiyo kwa niaba ya kundi hili wote kwa ujumla, naamini mnashukuru Mungu, tunamshukuru Mungu kwa ajili ya uhai ambao tunao. Karibuni kwa yeyote ambaye ana shukrani, shuhuda ama sifa. Kwa ukimya huo tuendelee na program, na kinachofuata sasa ni kipindi cha maombi. Ninapenda kuwakaribisha wana Tausi Pacific ambao watatupatia maombi kwa wakati huu. Nimkaribishe Mama Fino Taylor pamoja na dada Gesa kwa ajili ya kutupatia ombi. Na niseme tumshukuru Mungu kwa ajili ya uhai pamoja na kibali cha kuweza kuona siku nyingine kama ya leo. Pia tuweke programu hii mikononi mwa Mungu iweze kufanikiwa na iguse mmoja ama wawili popote pale tulipo. Na pia nishukuru uongozi mzima wa Tausi kwa kazi kubwa ambayo naifanya. Kwa namna hiyo basi, na tukumbuke vile wagonjwa popote walipo, tafadhali tuwaweke mikononi mwa Mungu. Ninawakaribisha sasa katika muda mzuri wa maombi. Tafadhali dada Gesa, tuanze kwa ombi, atafuata Mama Fino Taylor.
Basi tu uweze kumshukuru Mungu wakati huu. Baba mtakatifu leo mahali pa juu mbinguni, hatuna budi kurudisha shukrani zetu wakati huu wa jioni. Wana na binti zako tumekutanika kwa ajili ya kuleta shukrani na ibada mbele zako tunapoenda kufunga sabato. Tunasema asante muumbaji wetu, kwanza umetupatia uhai ambao ni bure. Sio kwamba tumetenda mema mbele zako, bali tumepata kibali na neema mbele zako. Utuhurumie na utusamie Baba. Tunaleta watoto wetu miguuni pako jioni ya sasa, walioko katika nchi ya ugeni huku na walioko huku nyumbani. Wote Bwana tunawaleta miguuni pako, kama Baba ikawe sadaka yenye manukato mazuri mbele zako, kwa ajili ya kuwasamehe dhambi zao na uweze kupata kibali machoni pako katika mambo yote unayoyafanya katika ulimwengu huu ambayo yanakupendeza wewe. Na daima Mungu kusimame pamoja nao. Tunawaleta watoto wetu kwa sababu tumepata shoku nyingi katika ulimwengu huu kwa ajili ya vijana wetu na mabinti zetu. Sasa Mungu, hatuna haja ya kuorodhesha, unajua ni nini ambacho tuna huzuni navyo. Wakati mwingine tunashikwa na mahuzuni kupita kiasi, lakini tunarudi na shukrani. Asante kwa sababu Baba ulikuwepo, hayo yote yakitokea na uliyaruhusu yaweze kutokea. Na sasa Mungu, kwa njia ambayo uliruhusu sisi hatuwezi kuelewa, ila mara nyingi tunasema ya kwamba tutakuja kujua ni kwa nini uliruhusu hayo yote ukayaacha yatokee. Tunazidi kurudisha shukrani, hakuna jingine la kuweza kusema, bali tunasema asante kwa uhai, asante kwa afya, asante kwa nguvu unazotupatia. Ninapoacha wenzangu waendelee kuomba, tunaomba kaunganishe maombi yetu pamoja pia. Naomba haya katika jina la Mwana wa Yesu Kristo. Amen.
Amina, amina. Tuombe. Baba Mungu uliyoko mbinguni, uliye juu sana, unayeangalia chini, unaotuona sisi wadhaifu, lakini unatuhurumia. Baba, asante kwa siku ya leo. Asante kwa kutukusanya wote hapa. Asante kwa kila mmoja aliyeko hapa. Asante kwa sabato yako njema. Baba, tunakushukuru kwa ulinzi wako, kwa upendo wako. Na zaidi ya yote tunashukuru kwa ajili ya Yesu Kristo aliyetufia msalabani ili tuweze kuja kwako kwa ujasiri. Tusamehe dhambi zetu Baba. Uliahidi ya kwamba tukija kwako kwa unyenyekevu utatusamehe na utatusikia maombi yetu Baba. Kuna wagonjwa wengi miongoni mwetu na wengine ambao hawapo hapa. Wengine ni ndugu zetu ambao wako mbali. Baba, tusikie maombi yetu, waponye wote kwa magonjwa yao yote. Sio magonjwa ya kimwili tu, ila pia magonjwa ya kiroho. Maana sote tungependa kuwa nawe siku ile utakapokuja. Tunashukuru kwa ajili ya maombi yaliyotangulia. Baba, sikia maombi yetu wote. Kuna watu wengi hapa walio na mahitaji mbalimbali ya kiroho. Mengine wanaweza kuyasema, mengine yako moyoni ndani sana. Lakini wewe unayafahamu. Unafahamu shida zetu zote. Baba, tusaidie. Tunashukuru kwa ajili ya Tausi. Tunashukuru kwa kutupa nafasi sisi kujiunga na wewe kwenye kazi yako ya Mungu. Baba, tafadhali utubariki kwa yale madogo tunayoyatenda. Lakini mkono wako ukituongoza yanaweza kuwa makubwa. Baba, tunaomba kwamba usaidie huduma ya leo, uibariki. Kila mmoja akitoka hapa aseme ya kwamba ilikuwa vizuri kuwa pamoja na watu wako na kusikiliza neno lako. Tuomba haya tukitarajia kwa ajili ya jina la Yesu Kristo Mwokozi wetu. Amen.
Niseme asante dada Gesa pamoja na mama Fino Taylor kwa huduma hiyo ya maombi. Mungu awabariki sana. Basi, kipindi kinachofuata ni kipindi cha kupata neno la Mungu. Na kwa siku ya leo Mungu ametupatia kibali cha kuweza kuhudumiwa na mtumishi wake ambaye ni mchungaji Christopher Mwashinga kutoka Embus. Ninasema asante mchungaji kwa kukubali wito na asante kwa kuwa bado unafanya kazi ya Mungu tena kubwa sana kwa uaminifu na katika mazingira yote. Kwa siku ya leo basi Tausi ina furaha ya kukaribisha katika muda huu ili uweze kutuhudumia. Karibu mchungaji.
Asante sana dada. Na nyinyi mnanisikia? Okay, good. Asante sana. Nafurahi kuona imekuwa muda mrefu tangu nilipoongea nanyi kwa mara ya mwisho hapa. Kwa hiyo nafurahi kuona watu wengi, nimejaribu kupitia haraka haraka hapa naona watu wanazidi kuingia na nimebarikiwa kuona watu wengi tayari. Asante dada Gesa na kundi lako kule Oregon, meimba vizuri sana sana sana. Mungu awabariki na asanteni sana dada zangu ambao mmetuwakilisha katika maombi siku hii ya leo. Kwa kweli napenda kumshukuru Mwenyezi Mungu kwa nafasi aliyotupatia ya kukutana hapa pamoja siku ya leo. Na mshukuru vile vile Pastor Migombo ambaye ni chaplain wetu kiongozi kwa kazi nzuri anayoifanya, kwa kweli kazi kubwa na nzuri. Na kwa kunipa assignment mimi nifanye leo hapa. Kuna machaplain kadhaa, yeye ndiye kiongozi wetu anatupangia kazi. Kwa hiyo leo aliniambia kwamba niongee pamoja nanyi. Na mimi nafurahi kuongea pamoja nanyi. Vile vile napenda kusema maneno mawili matatu ya affirmation kwa kazi kubwa ambayo viongozi wetu wa taifa na viongozi wa chapters kila mahali ambao wamekuwa wakifanya kwa muda wote huu. Kabla ya mwaka jana, ambao mwaka wetu uliisha wakati wa retreat na kuanza mwaka mwingine, na sasa wamekuwa wakiendelea tena vizuri katika mwaka huu mpya wa Tausi. Mungu awabariki sana sana. Kazi mnayofanya ni kubwa na mjue tu kwamba thawabu yenu ni kubwa mbinguni vile vile sababu Mungu ameahidi. Baada ya kusema hayo, I think I will just go straight to our message today and I think some people have to bear with me here. I just hope that people will be able to get the message even though I decided to change the language here because I did not have time to do this thing in Kiswahili. I just didn't have time. So I will try to present this brief message in English, and I hope that some maybe all of us, I understand that many people here really speak the language, so they should not have any problem. I just hope and pray, because it doesn't make sense if anybody doesn't get the message. So I hope that somehow God will be able to communicate this message to each one of us here tonight. And the message tonight is the joy of crying out to God. And let me pray again for this message. Dear loving Father, we thank you so much for the privilege you have given us and for the gift of life and for the gift of your word. I pray that as we share this message tonight, dear loving Father, your Holy Spirit would make this message clear to each one of us here tonight. And I pray that after this message is presented and everything is said here, the glory and honor will come to you. In Jesus' name, amen. So the joy of crying out to God. Tonight, I want to share with you a message on the subject of prayer. I will approach this message from a different angle because I believe that prayer is one of the most basic, disciplines of Christian of the Christian church, I should say. You may do whatever thing you want to do. You may do programs, you may plan things out and everything, but if prayer is not involved, all those other things may not get anywhere. They may not be successful. You may be successful to some extent, but big projects that calls for, bigger investments must involve a lot of prayer. And tonight I want to share with you something that would kind of remind us of this thing. And I believe that in some way, the subject of prayer must be brought to our people every now and then so that we don't forget, especially now that we live in a world where many people don't care very much about prayer because they think that they can get away with so many things without even praying. And Christians, not just Adventists, Christians of other denominations as well, they have found that many people don't pray as much as they used to do before. So it's so important that every now and then we bring this thing back to us, and at least one aspect or two aspects of it, even when we don't have much time. So I will try to share with you a message that is found in the book of First Chronicles, chapter 4, and I'm going to read verse 9 and verse 10. And if you can please go with me there. I usually encourage people to read their Bibles. If you have your paper Bible or your electronic device, whatever it might be, you want to locate that, actually it's just two verses, that passage, very short passage. Once you have it, I'll give you maybe 15 seconds. Then when you get there, we'll read it together, and then I will share this message with you tonight. You have 15 minutes, or rather seconds, to get there. All right, I think the 15 seconds expired. So let's read this together. It's First Chronicles chapter 4, verses 9 and 10. The Bible says, Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. His mother had named him Jabez, saying, I gave birth to him in pain. Jabez cried out to the God of Israel, oh, that you would bless me and enlarge my territory. Let your hand be with me and keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain. Bible says, the last part of this verse, it says, and God granted his request. That is to say, every single aspect of his prayer, of his request, was granted by God. And this, it seems to me, makes it important that we look into this this short prayer here and wonder what is it in there that makes God answer every single aspect of it. Actually, there are four points that we can really pull out of this small passage here, the short passage here tonight. And that is exactly what I want to do with you here. But before I go to those four points, and again, what I'm sharing with you is a short version of this message because of the time that we have. But before I go to the four points, let me just say that this brief account of this man known as Jabez is so brief that we don't know much about this man. Even though when you read his prayer, it's one of the greatest prayers in all the Bible, but not much is said about him, except that his mother, gave birth to him, in pain. And so he decided to call him Jabez. But when you go to Hebrew, the Hebrew language, the Old Testament was written in Hebrew and Aramaic. So you go to the Hebrew language, you don't find any meaning here. So it makes us think that somehow maybe his name is associated with the pain because his mother said that he named him Jabez because he gave birth to him in pain. So not much is known. And this allows me, time to go straight to the four points that I want to share with you here tonight. But now, when you come to this prayer here, as we kind of reflect on this passage, what surprises me when I read here is not the prayer itself, but is the way this man prayed and the way God answered. We have heard so many prayers. You, my listeners, have prayed so many times. I have too, so many times, in many ways. Sometimes we write those prayers out so that they can sound the way we want them to sound, as if we think if we did it that way, God would answer quickly because, of the way we have arranged those prayers. So we have prayed so many times. But what surprises me is that this guy prays these four points and God grants or answers every single one of them. Every single one of them. For the Bible says God granted them all. He granted those requests. 4 points. What is it special in the 4 points that God should answer every single one of them? I was thinking as I was preparing this message that anyone in the world, any Christian, at least I know I can speak for myself. I would want to know if I knew there was a way that if I prayed in certain ways, God would say yes every time I prayed and he would answer my prayer with a yes answer. Then I would want to know that secret so that all my prayers would be answered with a yes answer. So this man prays this prayer. The Bible says that he cried out to the God of Israel. That's why our title here is The Joy of Crying Out to God. The joy of enjoying crying out to God. So this man cried out to God, and the Bible says that he cried out to God and said, oh, that you'd bless me indeed. The Bible here does not tell us if he had a preamble to his prayer. You know, sometimes our Father who art in heaven, like Jesus taught, and that must be our really super example of how to pray, because the disciples asked Jesus to teach them to pray, and he taught them that they should pray that way. But this man does not begin that way. The Bible says that this man cried out to the God of Israel, and he said, point number one, oh, that you would bless me indeed. And some people, commentators, have said that it was selfish of him to ask God to bless him. It's like the first thing he wanted to get from God was blessings. And it sounds somehow selfish. And some people have said that we shouldn't pray that way because of that element of selfishness that seems to come out of this phrase here, this point number one. But then when you read there, you have to ask yourself the question, if he was selfish, would God bless him? Would God grant his request? The fact that he prayed and asked God to bless him and God gave him, or God answered his prayer, granted his request, whether we call it selfish or that the prayer was selfish or not, it's immaterial at this point. Because God said yes. If God says yes, who can say no? So he prayed and he said, oh, that you would bless me. And God blessed him. And actually he says, that you would bless me indeed. That is to say, you would bless me beyond measure. Bless me indeed. And the Bible says that God blessed him indeed. So what I want to suggest here tonight is that when you pray, it may be helpful. When you wake up in the morning, you begin by asking God to bless you. You ask God to bless you before you wait for other people to say, God bless you, God bless you. What if they forgot to bless you? When you wake up in the morning, the first thing is for you to ask God to bless you. And according to this text here, if you ask God to bless you, God would not say no, he would bless you. If you did ask him to bless you, he would bless you. If you ask him to bless your children, he will bless your children. So I say today, thousand members, and some people may say, well, I don't wake up in the morning because I work all night. Well, if you work night shifts, you can choose any time you want to spend with God and ask God to bless you. But let's say that you wake up in the morning. First thing you want to do is to ask God to bless you. And I would add and say, ask God to bless your spouse. Ask God to bless your children. Ask God to bless your parents. Ask God to bless your loved ones. First thing in the morning, and God would always say yes, just like he did to this man. And that's not too hard to do. Am I asking too hard a thing of you? I don't think it's that hard. Just ask God to bless you. And it's not selfish. Ask him to bless you, and he will bless you. So this man asked God to bless him. And I'll go to the second point, because I want to make sure that at least this message is clear, but it's also done within the time that we have. But point number two, this man says, enlarge my territory. You have all these points in verse 10, so I may not go back and forth, but you have it in verse 10. The second point, it says, enlarge my territory. In other words, increase my territory, increase my influence. And the Bible says, when he prayed that God should enlarge his territory, God said, yes, you also have that one. And God says, yes, you have it. He answered his prayer with a big yes answer. He granted his request. Now, I want you to come with me because I want you to understand that there's a way this man is praying here. It's like it's an art and science of prayer here. The way he does it, he starts by asking God to bless him. Then he moved to the second level. He says, enlarge my territory, increase my influence. If he is a businessman or woman, he asks God to grow his business or her business, maybe 10 times over or 100-fold. If he is an employee somewhere, he asks God to facilitate his promotion so he can make more money and be a big blessing to many people in his community. Or if he's a student, then he asks God to make him or her more successful in his or her studies. And if he's just a community person, he asks God to increase his influence in the community or in society so that he can do more for Christ. And what surprises me here, God does not ask questions that, oh, so you want me to bless you and you also want to have a larger territory than you already have? What is the motivation here? God does not ask those questions. The Bible says God goes ahead and he blesses him. He grants his request again. So he blesses him and he enlarges or he increases his territory. Now, I want you to put your finger there. I'll come back to that. Now, let us go to point number three in his prayer. Now, I told you that when you read this, you see that this guy is doing it in such a way that there's a level of progression here. He starts by asking God to bless him. Then he goes to the next level. He says, enlarge my territory. And with all other things that would fall under that one. And now he goes to the third level. He asks God and he says, let your hand be with me. Some other translations say, let your influence, rather, your presence be with me. Or your presence go with me. Because he knows that when you are so blessed, your territory has been so much enlarged. You pray for big projects. You come up with mega projects, your personal projects, which are big, mega projects. He knows that those projects, when they are too big, there's no way he can accomplish them as a human being without having this help from God. So he says, your hand, allow your hand to be with me. Oh, that your hand would be with me. Your presence would go with me. Because he knows that once you are blessed, your territory has been enlarged, and you have these mega projects, you need God's help to accomplish those plans and those projects. So he asks God to go and help him out. And the Bible says, this one also, God did not even blink. He just went ahead and blessed him and enlarged his territory. And number three, God decided that he was going to go with him. His hand was going to be with him. His presence was going to be with him. And that's why I think it's so important that when we pray, we must pray with a level of understanding. We must not pray, babbling like some people do. You just pray as if you have a checklist. You just want to go there quickly. We must pray strategically. We must know why we are praying, or we are saying what we are saying in our prayers. This man knew, and it seems to me that he had a goal in life. He knew what he wanted to accomplish in this world. He knew why he came into this world. And he knew he had a vision for his life. He knew that he needed God's blessings because he was a follower of God, because he was an Israelite. Today, we say because he was a Christian, a follower of Jesus Christ, he knew that he did not come to this world by chance or by accident. He came here for a purpose, and he wanted to live his life to the full and accomplish the purpose for which God brought him into this world. So when he prays with that mind. He says, bless me, enlarge my territory. Or not only that, but also I beseech you that your presence will go with me. Because to accomplish big projects need the help of God. But I will tell you today that he also knew that when God is with him, nothing would stop him. When God is with you, you become unstoppable. Nothing can stop you. Because all insurmountable things become surmountable. And unconquerable becomes conquerable when the presence of God is with you. When the presence of God is with you, there is no terrain that you cannot traverse. There are no rivers that you cannot cross. There are no mountains that you cannot climb. And there's no destiny that you cannot fulfill. When the presence of God is with you, you become almost unstoppable. And he knew that. That's why he's asking God to go, to allow his presence to go with him. When the hand of God is with you, even the sky cannot limit you as a child of God. So when you pray, my brothers and sisters, Taos members, always pray with that, pray with understanding. Not to just fulfill some obligations, kind of. Know why you are praying, what you are praying. Say what you need to say. Knowing that you have a big God in heaven who is looking down on you. He's waiting for you to ask for big things. And he's ready to bless you. So number one, he says, bless me. Number two, enlarge my territory. And number three, he says, let your presence go with me. Let your hand go with me. And God also granted that one. That is to say, he allowed his presence to go with him. He allowed to be with him. He had a company. He had a company in God. Wherever he went, he knew that the presence of God was with him. Nothing could really push him around. He knew that an almighty God was there with him. When you know that, you know what? It kind of boosts your self-concept, your self-esteem. No matter what people say, when you know that you are blessed, even if people should not bless you, you know that God has already blessed you. When you go out of your house or your apartment, you're going to work, you go out there, you know that God is with you. Nothing can stop you from doing what you need to do as God has called you to do. Even if some people should not be nice to you at your workplace, you know that God has already blessed you. Actually, even if people should curse you, you know that God has already blessed you. So even your self-concept goes up so that when you talk to other people, even your attitude toward other people and toward God and toward yourself changes. If it was negative, now it becomes positive. Why? Because you know that the presence of God is with you. When you come back home to your family, you're a different person. When you go out of your home to work or to school or to do your business, you're a different person. You know that God is with you. No matter what people say, will not change your attitude because it's anchored in God. So this man says, hey, may your presence go with me, or your hand go with me. But there's point number four. Point number four, this man prays and asks God, he says, keep me from evil. Some other translations say, keep me from sin so that it will not be for my pain. He tells God, he asks God, or he cries out to the God of Israel, to the God of heaven. And he says, bless me, enlarge my territory. And he says, and like we saw here, he says, and let your presence go with me. And he knows once you have those three, you become unstoppable. You become very influential in the world. You become famous. You may become rich or anything, because we have been called to do different things in this world. But in any way, people will take note of you, will take notice of you. And he knows when that happens, there is a danger. People who go all the way to the summit, there's a danger of starting going down again on the other side. We know so many people who got so much blessed by God, and you guys know so many people as well. I know so many people, and you know, even here in the US and back home and elsewhere, you know some people who are so blessed, so talented, and they did so much good for the world. Then when they became so rich, and when they became so famous, and when they knew, they reached a point where they knew that they were better, they thought maybe they were better in terms of money and other things than other people, they started thinking that it was possible for them to live or to stand on two different platforms. The platform of God and the platform of Satan. They thought they could still maintain their Christianity while they're drinking from the fountain of the world. And before they knew it, they started going down. And we know some of them who died either of incurable diseases, or they got shot, or something just happened to them. And some of them are still suffering in different parts of the world today. And this man knew that after being so successful, and this also tells us about the faith of this man. When he asked God to bless him, he knew, he believed that God would bless him, and God blessed him. When he asked God to enlarge his territory, he believed that God would enlarge his territory and increase his influence, and God did. When he asked God that he should go with him, his presence, his hand, they should go with him wherever he went, he knew that God would say yes because of his faith. Remember, he says all these things in this prayer before they happen. So he prays before they happen. And then after that, all these things happened when God said yes to every single one of them. So since he knew that these things were going to happen, he also knew that he needed some protection from God. He knew these things, I'm going to ask God about these things, and God is going to give me these things. But now when I get there, when I'm somewhere there at the top, some things will come in and try to undermine the very thing that I asked God for. So I need some protection. So he goes to God, point number four. He says, keep me from sin. Keep me from evil. He wants to cling with God for the rest of his life. Because he knows that if he allows sin into his life, everything that he has built for whatever length of time would go down the drain. And so he asks God to help him to keep him from evil or to keep him from sin. And he gives some sort of a reason there because he says, so that it will not be for my pain. My brothers and sisters, sin brings pain. You know, some people even here who, before they came to this country, all of us have come to this, most of us have come to this country from home. Whether we live in here in the US or in Canada, we came from home or from some other African countries. We came here. And those of us who were already Christians before we came here as strong Christians. But when we came here, the Lord blessed us. We became, we got more money. Let me put it that way. We started living a little better life, and we thought that we are chasing this American dream, and we are almost getting there. We thought that we got to that point all by ourselves without God. After we reach that point, we forget about God. We begin doing the very things that God has told us not to do. And before we know it, we begin going down, and we know people. We know people who have been going down, and some people have been lost. But this message, the good thing with this message is that it still allows us time. We can still go back to God and say, you know what? I messed up there. I messed up over there. Please bless me again. Please help me out. But the most important thing, we must say no to sin. This man decided that he was not going to entertain sin in his life. So he says, God, keep me from sin so that it will not be for my pain. There are so many people in the world today who are rich, but they are suffering in their deathbed somewhere there. Some of them are in hospital, even though they have mansions all over the place. They cannot even live in those homes because they are too sick to live in those homes. They have transitioned to a hospital somewhere. So having money, having fame, having the increased influence, having all these things, if you cannot have you cannot keep your health together. If you still can go into pain, what is the point of having all the things that we sometimes cry for or even die for? This man knew that if he were to live a life that is decent, a life that would praise God, he also wanted to be free from pain because he said that I may be free from pain. So let me say this, I can see that time is running out here. My brothers and sisters, the Lord has blessed us in many ways, different ways, each one of us here, young and old, males and females. God has blessed us in a very special way. Those who are born in Africa, and those who are born and here, and those who have grown up right here. God has called us to be his people, to follow him. He tells us that when we ask him to bless us, he will bless us. When we ask him to enlarge our territories and increase our influences, he will answer that and increase our territories and our influences. When we ask his presence to go with us, God will say, yes, I will go with you. But God is pleading with us again tonight that sin must be put away, must always be put away from our lives. We cannot try to live that double standard. Some people think that God will... Some people say, well, but God knows that this is not my country, so there are things that I can't do. No, there's no middle way. We are either followers of Christ or we are not. Christianity does not have that middle way. That's why in the Old Testament, Joshua will tell you, choose ye this day whom you shall serve. And in the New Testament, several passages in the New Testament. Jesus himself said, you cannot serve two masters. Because if you did, then you would love this one and hate the other one. And in the last book of the Bible, the book of Revelation, Jesus Christ says again, he says again that I would rather you be cold or hot. But if you maintain neutrality in Christianity, says that lukewarmness, I will spew you out of my mouth. I will vomit you out of my mouth. That tells you that in Christianity, there is no neutral ground. You are either a follower of Christ or you are not. So as we live our lives, ask God to bless us. He will bless us. We ask him to go with us. He will go with us because he has promised. We ask him to give us success. He will give us success. But we must also pray that God will keep us from sin so that it will not be for pain. Otherwise, we'll not enjoy the very things that we have harvested or we have accumulated for ourselves in this country. So I urge you tonight, as I close, that we may consider these 4 points. You want to be successful? That's good, and God likes it. Ask for big blessings, God will bless you. You want to be more influential in this country and this world than you have ever been before? That's a good ambition. God will bless it. God will enlarge your territory. You want the presence of God to go with you wherever you go? God will be ready to go with you. But again, God says you have to keep that sin thing away. Keep it away. Keep it away. So that the blessings will continue to flow in your life and the lives of the loved ones. Ask God to bless you first when you wake up in the morning. First thing in the morning, ask him to bless you and all the other things that I've shared with you tonight. May God bless you tonight, my brothers and sisters. May we put these things into practice. And after a few months, let us look back and see what will happen to us. How many people will have been blessed so much here in this group. And will be a blessing to other people as well. May God bless you tonight. In Jesus, amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Asante sana mchungaji Mwashinga kwa huduma hii ya neno la Mungu. Tunashukuru kwa ujumbe huu mzito sana. And today, may God bless us. May God enlarge our territories. May his hands be with us. And may God keep us away from sin. And that will be our prayer today and always. Asante sana kwa ujumbe huo. Na amini kila mmoja wetu amebarikiwa. Na Mungu akubariki kwa huduma hii. Asante. Na kipindi kinachoendelea sasa ni kipindi cha wimbo. Wimbo wetu wa pili utaletwa na Becky. Tafadhali Becky, kama uko mahali hapa, tunakukaribisha wakati huu.
Asante. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Nitaimba wimbo kutoka katika kitabu cha SDA Hymns. Not sure ni namba ngapi, lakini ni wimbo usemao Wonderful Merciful Savior. Mbarikiwe.
Merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and friend, who would have thought it around could rescue the souls of men? Oh, you rescue the souls of men. Counselor, Comforter, Keeper, Spirit belong to embrace. You offer hope when our hearts are hopelessly lost away. Oh, with hopelessly lost the way. You are the one. You give the healing grace our hearts always hunger for. All our hearts always one will find. Almighty, infinite Father, faithful and loving, your own, the right awareness you find us falling before your throne. Oh, we're falling before your throne. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give the healing and grace our hearts always hunger for. Our hearts always hunger for. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give the healing and grace.
Amen. Asante dada Beka kwa wimbo huu mzuri sana. Mungu akubariki sana. Basi tunakaribia kufikia mwisho wa kipindi hiki cha siku ya leo ya programu ya Tausi Fellowship and Worship. Na kwa niaba ya uongozi mzima wa Tausi, mimi ninaitwa Nanyuni Kisaka, ni mmoja wa viongozi wa Tausi nikiwa nasimamia Pacific Chapter. Nipende kuwashukuru wote waliohudumu siku ya leo, nikiwa na kwa upande wa maombi ya kufungua ambaye kiongozi wetu kwa Spouse Pacific ni dada Sifa Eliamani, waliotupatia maombi siku ya leo. Kwa kufungua alitupatia ndugu Isaac Nziacharo, aliyetupatia ombi la kufunga ni dada Gesa pamoja na mama Fino. Wimbo wa kwanza tuliletewa pia na dada Gesa pamoja na kundi zima la Oregon. Naamini wengi tumebarikiwa kwa wimbo huo. Na wimbo wa mwisho tumepatiwa na dada Beka. Tafadhali tunawashukuru na pokeeni shukurani zetu. Neno la leo limeletwa na mchungaji wetu Christopher Mwashinga. Tumebarikiwa sana kwa ujumbe huo. Na kwa niaba ya uongozi mzima wa Tausi Pacific, nipende kumshukuru Mungu kwa kipindi hiki na kibali hiki cha kuweza kuhudumu siku ya leo. Mungu awabariki sana. Na kabla sijatoka mahali hapa, kama kuna matangazo, nitamkaribisha ndugu Soga Bilinyi kwa ajili ya matangazo ya Tausi. Na baada ya hapo tu, sauti itakayofuata itakuwa ni sauti ya Isaac Nziacharo, atakuwa anasimamia kipindi cha mazungumzo baada ya habari. Basi Mungu awabariki mnapoendelea kuburudika, kuhudumika na kufarijika kwa namna mbalimbali. Asante sana. Karibu ndugu Soga.
Asante dada Nanyuni. Habarini za jioni wanatausi. Natumaini wote mmebarikiwa kwa huduma ya leo. Kwa upande wangu ningependa tu kuhamasisha tu na matoleo kwa ajili ya project za Tausi za mwaka huu. Kama mnavyojua tuliweza kufunga mwaka wetu wa fedha Julai, na tumeanza mwaka mpya wa fedha kuanzia August 1. Kwa hiyo tuko katika miezi ya kwanza, kwa hiyo tuendelee kuhamasishana katika chapter zetu kuweza kuleta katika Tausi ili tuweze kufund hizo project mbalimbali ambazo tumepangilia kwa mwaka huu wa fedha. Kwa hiyo nashukuru wote kwa kweli mlivyojitolea mwaka jana, ilikuwa ni mbaraka mkubwa. Kwa hiyo tuendelee na hamasa hiyo na tutaweza kukamilisha budget yetu ya mwaka huu. Kwa hiyo nitarudishia mwenyekiti wa Tausi National Bwana Shukrani Magoma ili aweze kuendelea na matangazo mengine. Kwa matoleo, platform ni zile zile, kuna Cash App yetu ya Tausi, Zell, na unaweza kuwasiliana pia na mwenyeviti au waadhini wa chapter yenu. Najua chapters nyingi zinakuwa na drives mbalimbali, kwa hiyo wasiliana na mwenyekiti au mwadhini wako au chuma mchango wako pia kwenye Cash App na Zelle za Tausi, na zicompile na kushirikiana na wenyeviti na wazini wenu kukamilisha bajeti ya mwaka huu. Asanteni. Na mwenyekiti Magoma, karibu kwa matangazo mengine. Asanteni.
Asante sana muhazini.